Hi, and welcome back to La Mystique's Sketchbook. Today, we're going to play a game. So, I said that we're going to play a game, and that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to play the Zentangle game. So this is not my creation, I'm going to be honest, but I saw someone who had done a video on it, I want to say a few years ago, and there was a downloadable, a PDF that you were able to print out. And I went to try to go print it out, and it was a page not found. So I thought this is the perfect thing for everyone else just like me. Here's what you're going to need. Here's the things you're going to need to play the game. First, you're going to need a pair of dice. Next, you're going to need to create Zentangle pattern cards. So I have created two already. But if you wanted to go and take this on the road with you out, then you're going to create one on a basic tile. So for that one, it has six squares, and it's going to make much more sense here in a moment. Today, we're going to play using one of the squares I've already created. You might recognize these because I used these in the last two videos. I'm going to have links to those videos down in the description below. We're actually going to use this one today. You're going to need to have some kind of paper or a tile, and today I'll actually be using a regular tile. You're going to need to have your sketching pencil, either a Micron pen or a Sharpie. I'm going to use Micron pens today. You're probably going to want to have other things that you use to make Zentangles. You're going to want to have an eraser. I might use a white jelly roll pen. I'm not really sure yet. And I use all the things that I use to shade. That's just what you do. So here's how you play the game. Stay tuned. Just like every Zentangle, we need to create a string on our paper. So, I'm going to create four dots. And then I'm just going to draw a basic string. And I think for today's tangle, I think that's going to be it. So we've now created our Zentangle starting piece. So let's go ahead and start to play the game. So with every game, you're going to need to have a game board. And that is where our Zentangle game board comes into place. So you're going to notice that on the top, it is numbered 1 through 6. And along the left, it is also numbered 1 through 6. I've done this, as you can imagine, because this is where your dice comes in. We're going to roll the dice, and the dice that's on the farthest left, you can just choose either one. I'm going to choose the first one up here. We're going to go 1, 2, 3. And then down 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I need to make this tangle pattern. I need to make this somewhere in my Zentangle. So this really does take all the thought out of doing a Zentangle. So I am actually think I'm going to make it come out this way. That's kind of what I'm envisioning. Let me grab my Micron pen. So, I'm just creating basically that same pattern that I did here. And I'm just laying it down. I'm actually going to modify it a little bit. There we go. So, some of the basic rules of this game is you have to use the pattern that's there. But you can modify it as well. This is really just kind of like I said, help you go and take some of that thought out of it because Zentangle is supposed to be kind of spontaneous and not really a whole lot of thought going into it, but we like these patterns, but we have to think about them ahead of time. Well, what if we just put them onto a playing board, all of our favorites, or maybe ones we're really good at? Why not do it that way? I would love to say that I came up with this, but I didn't. This was actually the. There was someone else that did this. I'm going to go in and put that person down below. The reason why I am actually doing this is because there was supposed to be a downloadable that I came across it and there was a downloadable and I was going to go and download the PDF and well, there was no PDF. So I decided at that time, well, you know what? I guess that I can always do this, and that way I can make sure that people have that PDF if they want it. So there will actually be a PDF if you want to go in and get a copy of this game board for yourself. There is going to be that link. I'll put that down inside the description. actually, you know what? I'm going to put a card right there. So if right above where the picture is where there's going to be a link, and that way you can get a copy of a full page Zentangle board. Go ahead and just shade this. This is actually the first time I've used these artist tiles. I'm kind of liking them. They seem to be a lot smoother than the Zentangle tiles I was using. I think I like that. Make this a little bit darker, and then I'll actually come in with my darker pencil to give that shadowed look. Let's come in with my darker pencil. And I'm also going to come in here and make that look a little bit 3D too. Use my tortillion. All right, so I'm gonna kind of stop here, but there's tons of things I could be doing with this. Let's go ahead and move into our next pattern. So we're going to take our dice. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Ah, my piano keys, awesome. All right, so the piano keys, I could do this several ways. I think I'm gonna modify this tangle just a little bit because if I don't, then I'm gonna have one great big thing of piano keys. All right, so for our piano keys, I think I'm gonna make those piano keys come around here. Thank you. And for my piano keys, I have a pattern of 3, 2, and then it repeats. I don't think I'm going to have the opportunity to actually do more than that. So here's my 3. I guess I will. Let's do 3. Very nice. I kind of think I like the way this is going. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to create the line. Separates it. And for our piano keys, here I actually did make a rather solid line. So let's start it here. Kind of digging the way that this is coming out like this too, so okay. Probably should get my Sharpie for this. I like using my Sharpie to fill in the bigger pieces. Because it has a little bit thicker of a nib on it, so it's going to cover a lot more ground. And let's face it, Sharpies are cheaper. All right, very good. So, I have finished one pattern. Let's go ahead and roll the dice again. 1, 2, 3. I think that's gonna be perfect. I think I'm gonna put this right here in the middle. I think we could put it like this. The way that we do this, we're just going to create these little rice shapes. Perfect. Let's go ahead and shade that a little bit. In here, I really don't want this to be extremely dark. On the sides, I am going to go and make it a little bit darker because I really kind of want to make it show as though the light is coming from the center. add just a little bit more dark in there. Just going over them a little bit more. All right. Very nice. And let's roll the dice again. One, two. I'm not sure how we're going to do this one. I think I have an idea. I think. Okay. Yeah, here we go. Okay. I think we're going to take this all the way around. It just seems to make sense. So hopefully this kind of helps you understand the Zentangle game, the thought, general thought behind it. It just helps you take some of that thinking out of it. What you're going to do is you're going to take all of your favorite patterns and you're just going to put them onto this 6x6 grid. That way, roll the dice, and who knows what kind of a tangle you're going to come up with. I've thought about ways that you can actually modify it, because let's face it, some of us really love our tangles, right? So what you could do is you could have multiple pages and maybe you roll the dice multiple times before you find your first pattern. So let's say you have more than one of these patterns. You can roll the die. I'm going to go to my second page. And now I'm going to actually get my pattern. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That could be one way you do it. So here I'm just going to finish my tangle off. Actually, I think I'm going to come in here. Let's add some dark space to this. Need my eraser so I can erase some of these lines. And yes, I know I should have erased my lines before I started to shade, and I should have done all of mine together, but I really wanted to kind of show you how the game works, so I kind of got a little bit too excited. I don't think it detracts away from it at all. Just finishing the finishing touches. I like these blurred out lines. To me, it kind of makes it look as though it's standing up off of the paper. I do believe that is just about going to finish off my tangle. I have decided to come in here and make this black though. And all that's left is to sign it. Hopefully you have enjoyed my Zentangle game. Like I said, I'm going to have the game boards. I'm going to have blank ones down inside of the description for you. if you want to create something that is a little more portable, go ahead and take one of the tiles that you have. You can use a 3x3 card, or you can use a, this is actually a 4x4 card, and just put 6 squares. Then all you need is just to number them. That's it. So it's something that's really easy. Zentangle by number, if you will, and take some of that guesswork out of it. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and please make sure that you give me a thumbs up, letting me know that you did like it. If you want to find out when the next video is going to be, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And as always, stay creative. Bye, guys.